And so we'll be looking at effective preparation part 3. Effective preparation part 3. January is what? Our month of what? Preparation. Say it now. January is what?
Preparation.
Month of what? Preparation. Say it again. January is the what? Month of what? Preparation. It's a month of preparation. It's our month of preparation. And then 2021 is our what? A year of what? Greater glory. So greater glory 2021, January what? Month of preparation. And indeed, it is a wonderful thing that January is our month of preparation, because we are preparing what? To explode in 2021. How many of you want to explode here? I want to explode in a positive way. When I say explode now, some people, their minds are beginning to think like terrorists. That's not what I mean. That is not the context. When I talk about explosion, I'm talking about expansion. You understand? But you see, there cannot be expansion and explosion if there is no direction. Even if you want to expand and explode, you want to expand and explode in the right direction. Am I correct? So it's very important that before you start expanding and exploding, you are what? You are headed for the what? The right direction. Or if you're climbing a wall, you want to make sure that the ladder is placed on the right wall. Because sometimes you can place the ladder on the wrong wall, and when you don't finally climb, reach the top, you're like, this is the wrong place. Then you start coming down again. That is not going to be our portion in Jesus' name. So we're looking at effective preparation part 3. We're looking at smart Christian goals. Look at your neighbor and say, smart Christian goals. Turn up this microphone for me. Put some highs for me. Smart Christian what? Goals. As a Christian, you ought to have goals. You cannot just be living your life like that. You remember what we said in the first Sunday this January? We said what? Write it what? Down. How many of us have written it down? Have you written it? All right. So, how to prepare to achieve those things you've written down? Those things you've written down that you want to achieve, those things are what? Your goals for the year 2021. Am I correct? Pay attention, or everybody pay attention. No distractions. Those things you've written down that you want to achieve this year, those things are what we call what? Goals. Huh? So each and every one of us that is present here has what? Goals. There are things we want to see happen in 2021. In our businesses, in our academics. Huh? Praise the Lord. Okay. So we want to take a look at the word goal. We're looking at what Christian goals. But let's start by defining the word goal. What a goal is. When I'm talking about goal in this context now, I'm not talking about Ronaldo and Barca against Juventus. I don't know, is Juventus still playing? Is he still a team? They're still there, okay. So that's not the goal. I'm not talking about football goal now. I'm talking about what? Objectives. Things you want to see. Now, the first definition of the word goal here that I have, even if I might be reading fast, but what I'll do is that I will upload what I have here on the church Facebook page. So you can go there after the service, you see it. But I'll be fast because I don't want to waste too much time. I'm already taking 10 minutes. So now, the object of a person's ambition or effort, a goal, is the object of a person's ambition or effort, an aim or desired result. Let me say it again. A goal is the object of a person's ambition or effort, an aim or desired result. Now, a goal is also the state of affairs that a plan is intended to achieve. Remember, Well, on the first Sunday, we talked about, this is our month of preparation, and I've been saying something that there's something that comes before preparation. I said it on the first Sunday. I said that you cannot be talking about preparation without having something in mind. If you just tell somebody, say, are they prepared? The next thing that a person will ask you will be what? Waiting you they prepare for. So there's something that comes before preparation. So before you begin to talk about preparation, you already have something, you already have the end, that you already have something in mind. There's a picture, there's a mental picture in your head. Am I correct? Yes, there's a mental picture first before you can talk about preparation. Are we listening? And I gave an example. I gave a very, very vivid and simple example that Sunday, on the first Sunday, when we were talking about preparation. I said, if you want to make what? Egusi soup. You already have what? The picture of the egusi soup in your what? In your mind. You don't already see them before you even start. So that egusi soup that is in your mind that you have seen now, that is the goal. That is your objective. That is your aim. You understand? Uh-huh. So what we want to look at this Sunday is, we want to look at the things that will make you, that is how to be able to what, package your goals. That's what we are looking at. I'm calling it what? Smart Christian goals. Praise the Lord. Now, a goal is also what? A goal is an aim or objective that you work towards with effort and determination. A goal is an aim or objective that you work towards with what? Effort and what? Determination. With effort. So in other words, you cannot achieve your goal by what? Sleeping. Can you go and sleep and then you say you want to achieve your goal? Is it possible? That you are sleeping and then you're... It's not possible now. If you have exams to write, you want to write exams, you're a student. I know we have a lot of students here. If you're a student, put your hand up. Let me see. If you're a student. Students are many. Even children, we have students, yes. So if you have exams, will you go and sleep? You don't sleep now when you have exams. What do you do? You read. You study. Even the Bible says, study what? To show thyself what? Approved. So you read. So, you put effort. You're determined. You don't tell yourself, say, okay, this year, this is what I want. And that thing you want is what is your goal for that year. Praise the Lord. Now, there's something we've defined a goal. There's also something that is known as goal setting. We know what a goal is now. We say a goal is an aim or objective that you work towards with what? Effort and determination. Now, let's look at goal setting. Now, the goal setting is what? It's a development of an action plan designed to motivate and guide a person or a group towards a goal. A goal setting is development of an action plan designed to motivate and guide a person or a group toward a goal. It is also a powerful process of thinking about your ideal future. And for motivating yourself to turn your vision of this future into reality. So when you're motivating yourself and you're trying to turn that your vision you have into reality, that is what is known as goal setting. Praise the Lord. Now, let's move on because I have a lot of things to say. In order for you to be able to achieve your goals must be smart. Look at your neighbor and say, your goals must be smart. Your goals must be what? Smart. And smart here is more or less like an acronym. Is that it in English? Okay. Acronym. Okay. And it stands for something. The S in smart stands for specific. Look at your neighbor and say, specific. In other words, your goals must be what? Specific. So in 2021, if you want to be an achiever in the year 2021, it then means that your goals must be what? Specific. You know, there are some people that when they run a company, you see they will put so company, we deal on this, that, this, towels, this, that, and general what? Contractors. Have you seen that kind of signboard before? We deal on this, 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 and what? General contractors. I cannot do business with that kind of company. Nervous. I need a specific what? Contractor. Most people that are achievers in life, if you check them, they are known for one thing. They are not. If I mention one name now, if I mention, let me mention a name. Let's see. A name that we all know. Let's see. Tiger Woods. What comes to your mind? Do you know Tiger Woods? Okay, golf. Okay. Specific. One thing comes to your mind. So for everybody that is a genius in life, for everybody that is an achiever, they are known for what? One thing. If I mention Julius Berger, what comes to your mind? Construction. Not Julius Berger. Say they do fishing. They are from fishing. Then they sell toilet roll for Mbiyama and Madiga. You can't be an achiever like that. The current richest man in the world, his name is Elon Musk. Have you heard that name before? Okay, that's the current. He has surpassed Jeff Bezos. That used to be he's into electric cars. And electric cars are the future. I was telling somebody, I said, between now and the year 2025 or 2035, we'll begin to see an influx of Chinese electric vehicles from China, here in Nigeria. We'll begin to see them on the road. And all these, your internal combustion, all these cars, then they will no longer be there again. They will be phased out. In fact, some countries in Europe, they are already putting, laws, restrictions, that by the year, some countries want to phase out gas that use fuel. Let me say it in the way that you understand. By the year 2030, 2035, if you have a car in the country and the car is using normal fuel, it is illegal. So the world is getting to that level now. So I put up a post on Facebook recently. I said, if you are a parent, you have to be futuristic. Don't send your child to go and study petroleum engineering, because very soon that course, you will read it and then you will not be able to find work, because the world has what? Moved on from fossil fuels. I'm telling you, the world has what? Moved on. The world is moving on now. Electricity is the future of humanity. Electricity. So if you are intelligent, if you're a parent, you'll be pushing your child towards that area. That's where to go. It's not petroleum engineering again. Because as far as I'm concerned, you know, permit me to say this. I'm digressing a bit. I know I have a lot to say, but let me say this. As far as I'm concerned, there will be a sharp decline for crude oil globally by, let's say, somewhere around 25 to 30% in the next 40 years. And we all know that in Nigeria, the concept of one Nigeria, the concept of all of us, nine get Nigeria, like recently I saw a video of one man from the north claiming the oil that is in the Niger Delta. The reason why it's like that is because of how valuable oil is. That is the truth. Let us say it. What is keeping Nigeria together today is the oil, because it is valuable. But as we keep living, oil will continue to lose its global relevance. It will happen. This is not a matter of how. Or whether it will definitely happen. It will happen. Oil will what? Lose its global relevance at some point. At some point, the keke you are driving now will be completely electrified. There will be no engine in it again. There will be what? Instead of an engine, there will be a battery inside that you'll be charging. We already have those cars. They are already there now. They're electric cars now. That name I mentioned, Elon Musk, he has a company in the US. It's called Tesla. So they make what? Electric vehicles. So if you're futuristic as a parent, you need to begin to do what? position yourself, even as an individual, begin to position yourself for the future. Let me say this again. I was discussing with somebody, my barber, yesterday. Please, let me say this. I said, I've been saying that the solution to Nigeria's electricity problem is not in the hands of the federal government. It is in the hands of technology. Now we have inverters and all of that, but the truth about the matter is that inverters are not affordable now. But at some point, they will become very affordable. The money that you are using to go and buy a generator is the same money you will now use to buy what inverter and put in your house. And at that point in time, everybody will now look for what? Scissors or knife to cut off the NEPA cables that are connected to your house, because you will be what? Generating what? Your own electricity. I'm telling you what will happen. The future. It's just like we are in this Yenagoa now. How many of you have government water in your house? You have from a water board. Let me see. None of us has that, Abi. I mean, I keep asking myself, I say, what is the function of water board? What are they doing? So individuals have been able to do what? To solve that problem themselves. We don't want dig borehole. Abi, you have borehole in your house. You are what? Generating your own water. You know they wait for government to come give you waiting water at all. You're not. You're not doing that. That is exactly the same thing that will happen with what? With electricity. And then recently I heard that the House of Assembly last year, they were trying to pass a bill that they want to tax people that have what? Boroughs. And then I heard one of the House members, he said that it is a very what? It is a stupid bill. We as governments, we have not been able to provide water for the people. We now want to come and tax them on top of the borehole they have dug in their own house. Does that make any sense? Absolutely not. So they struck the bill out. Thank God they did. Praise the Lord. So your goals must be what? Specific. I don't know why I'm saying what I'm saying, but the Spirit is just leading me to just tell you, because me, I read a lot. Your goals must be specific. So S stands for what? Specific. M stands for what? Measurable. Your goals must be what? Measurable. Measurable. Look at your neighbor and say, measurable. Measurable. Praise the Lord. Your goals must be achievable. Attainable. Your goals must be what? Achievable. Attainable. That's what A stands for. It stands for what? Achievable. Attainable. R stands for what? Your goals must be what? Realistic. Look at your neighbor and say realistic.
Realistic.
And then the T stands for timely. Your goals must be what? Timely. So in order for you to have smart goals, in other words, it means that what? They must be, your goals must be what? Specific, measurable, achievable or attainable, realistic, and what? Timely. So we're going to look at these things in details, and then we're going to read maybe some few scriptures, and then I'm going to round up. Now, let's start with specific. What it means for your goals to be what? Specific. Now, your goals need to be what? Clean and defined. Look at your neighbor and say, clean and defined. Your goals must be clean. In 2021, if you want to be an achiever, your goals must be what? Clean and defined. Remember what the Bible says in Habakkuk 2. It says what? Write the vision what? Make it plain, so that he that sees it what? Would run with it. All right. So now when you've written those things down, anyone should be able to read your goal and know exactly what you are trying to achieve. That's why we're saying what? Your goals should be what? Specific. You should not have general contractor goals. You're a general contractor. You do everything. Those people that do everything, they end up doing nothing. Be specific. Let your goals be what? Specific. I want 2 plots of land at Ekeki. Somebody will now ask you, you just write on the paper, say, I want land. You want, I don't understand, land. Is it swamp you want? Or is it 1 acre? Or is it half of half? Which one? Say what? I want what? 2 plots of land. At where? Ekeki? Or in Ekeki? That's where I want the land. Do you understand? You've been what? You've now specified that goal, Abi. Not just I want land. I want land is not a goal. I want 2 plots of land at Olubogbri. That is a goal. Praise the Lord. Because you're specific. Now let's look at the scripture, because I've been talking and we've not looked at any scriptures. Some people might be wondering why. Let's look at one. Matthew chapter 20 from verse 29 to 34. Look at your neighbor and say, be specific. In 2021, be specific. Matthew chapter 20 from verse 29 to 34. Put it on the screen for me. Let's look at it. It says, as they were leaving Jericho, a large crowd, what, followed him. Talking about Jesus. As they were leaving Jericho, what? A large crowd followed Jesus. Let's go on. 30. There were what? 2 blind men sitting by the road. When they heard that Jesus was passing by, they cried out, Lord, have mercy on us, son of what? David. Next verse. The crowd told them to what? Keep quiet. But they cried out all the more, Lord, have mercy on us, son of David. 32. Jesus stopped. Look at your neighbor and say, Jesus stopped. Jesus stopped, called them and said, what do you want me to do for you? Specific question. What do you want me to do for you? Oh my God. Hi. Chai. Okay. Hey, give me time. I can, I don't know. Cow, which one? Cow house? What am I call it? I'm not sure. Give me car. And then when you get home, you're like, hey, I don't make mistake. Oh, la house are for take. Oh, eh? So Jesus stopped, called them, and said, what do you want me to do for you? The next one, the next verse. Lord, they said unto him, open our eyes. Bam, they know, we're not coming here to play. We know what he carry us. Come. Open our eyes. What's happening? They were what? Specific. They knew what they wanted. They were not guessing. They didn't have many more. Father has a donkey. Mother can't remember. Many more. I wish I knew that with you born. 1, 2, 3. Look at your neighbor and say specific. Be specific. Be specific. Let your goals be what? Specific. I want my eyes to be what? Open. God will open the eyes and ears of our understanding in the year 2021 in Jesus' name. Amen. Yes. So we must be specific with our goals. Lord, they said what? To him, open our eyes. Let's go to the next verse. Moved with compassion, Jesus touched their eyes. Immediately they could see and they followed what? Man, no wasting time. No, go come, no come tomorrow. Say they come tomorrow. You know? Sharp. When I was about to get married, you know, there's this friend of mine. We're very close. He's a musician, but he's a banker. He's a big man. He can get money. So I just put my wedding kini on Facebook. He saw it. He saw it and he inboxed me. Sir Jerome, you want to marry? I say yes. He said, I should come and see him. So I went and saw him. We were sitting down. You know? He now asked me, said, this is your marriage where you want to marry. So now, what can I do for you? Hey! I know saying get money, but at that time, I never know saying get money like that. So he now asked me, he said, what do I do for you? He asked me. I said, well, just buy me my wedding suit and, you know, if you can do any other thing with some few drinks I need and blah, 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 and all of that. How much? He asked me. How much? Be specific. He asked me. How much is the money you need now? He asked me. Oh, he said, how much do you need? I just looked the guy. They pity the guy because, you know. I said, if I call now, make this guy no call, say, I dey greedy. So do you know what I said? I said, I just need 150,000. He said, send me your account number. I sent him there and then. In fact, my phone was in the car. By the time he just transferred the money, I said, I've sent you 150. I checked my phone. I saw it, 150,000. No, say, go tomorrow, come tomorrow. So when I left him, I now met my sister. My sister said, I said I was with Brata. If I call one other of my friend, said I was with Brata. Said, you were with Brata? I said, yes. I said, I just told him to say, this is how much I want. You see, you day with Brata, now 150,000, you go ask. What did they worry you, Seth? That's what they were telling me. Friends that knew him very well. So that guy is not a guy you're going to be asking for 150,000. You should have asked for like 500. They were telling me, that guy is that rich. He's in this town as I'm talking to you. If you see where he lives, even commissioners have not get that type of house. Big boy. I'm telling you this one, I'm telling you, Loha, I'm not hiding it. Just sent me the money, like, as in, go and marry. He was one of the people that helped me. I was what? I got what I asked for. They got what they what? They asked for. So this year, what are you what? Asking for. You should know what you want to what? Ask for. Be what? Be specific. Praise the Lord. Are you being blessed this morning? All right. Let's go on. Now, M stands for what? Measurable. Look at your neighbor and say what? Measurable. Measurable. Your goals in 2021 must be what? Measurable. They should be sizable. You know, if you look, make we look at. This is not the goal for this year. Praise the Lord. Now, how are you going to know that you're what? How are you going to know when you have reached these goals? Listen, to be rich and successful are not measurable goals. Eh? If you just say, I want to be rich and successful, you be general contractor as far as goals are concerned. You are not specific yet. You've not been able to define, you've not put your goals in perspective. Your goals are not what? Measurable. I want to be rich and famous. I want to have money is not a goal. How much money do you want to have? Then that goal becomes what? Measurable. For example, I want to save money. I want to what? Save money. I want to save money is not a goal. I want to save money is not a goal because that goal is what? It's not measurable. I want to save money. How much do you want to what? To save. Then it becomes measurable. So you now say, I want to be able, between January and October, I want to be able to save 500 what? 1,000. That becomes a measurable goal. Praise the Lord. Yes. So our goals must be what? Must be measurable. Praise the Lord. So I've given you an example now. The example is, I want to save money. Is not what? A measurable goal. I want to save 500,000. Is what? A measurable what? Goal. Let's look at Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11. Measurable goal. This is a popular scripture. It says, for I know the plans I have for you. This is the Lord's declaration. Plans for your welfare, not for what? Disaster. To give you what? A future and a hope. So it is not God's desire that what? That anything bad will befall us. It is not. It's not. Absolutely not. It is not. I love this scripture so much. Let's move on. I don't have time again. Proverbs chapter 21 verse 5. Proverbs what? 21 verse 5. Measurable goals. It says the plans of the diligent certainly lead to what? Profit. But anyone who is reckless only becomes what? Poor. The plans of the diligent. The plans of the what? The diligent. Mommy used to say something that those that diligently seek God are blessed. She likes to say that sentence a lot. So those who are diligent will know how to guide themselves so that they know how to make their plans, and then their plans will become what? They know how to make what? Measurable plans. The diligent. Since the plans of the diligent certainly lead to profit, lead to greatness, lead to increase. Profit there means increase, greatness, wealth. But anyone who is reckless, is anybody reckless here? Yeah? Do we have any reckless person? If you are reckless, stand up so that I can cast out the spirit of recklessness out of you. Okay, nobody's reckless. Only what becomes what? Poor. So poverty is what? Poverty is the gratuity of reckless people. It's the benefit. So when you are what? Reckless, you become poor. It shall not be our portion in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Now let's move on. Sharp, we're going on. So A, we're at A, right? Achievable or what? Attainable. Now most people fail because they go too big or too small. Your goals must be achievable. Your goals must be attainable. Listen, I'm reading something to you now. Most people fail because they go too big or too small. Too small and you achieve your goal in the first week, you might find it difficult to keep resetting and going after a new goal. Too big, your goal cannot be reached, deterring you from what? Going after it. Now, listen, getting God involved is the best way to find the goal that is just right for you. So in order for your goal to be achievable, first of all, you must what? Involve God in the planning phase. Praise the Lord. God must be what? Involved. And the God being involved is not that the plus Jesus minus Satan type of thing. No, that's not what I mean. You know, some people, when they want to eat, they will say plus Jesus minus Satan. Amen. Plus Jesus minus Satan. That's not what I mean. You have to do what? You have to pray. Huh? Are you listening? In order for you to be able to set achievable goals, God must be involved. And then you pray. You pray about it. All of this will help you come what to conclusion about what God wants you to what to do in life. The Bible says what we should commit what? Our works. We should commit our ways what into the hands of God. Abi? It's written in Proverbs. It's there. We'll look at one of those scriptures. So whatever goals you have set for yourself in 2021 must be what? Achievable. It must be what? Attainable. And you must what? Involve God in it. Look at your neighbor and say, involve God in your goals. Are you being blessed this morning?
Yes.
Let's look at Zechariah chapter 4 verse 10. Zechariah. I like the name Zechariah. Zechariah chapter 4 verse 10. It says, for who scorns the day of small things? These seven eyes of the Lord, which scan throughout the whole earth, will rejoice when they see the plumb line in Zerubbabel's hand. Can you take us to King James? Let me see it in King James. For who had despised the days of small beginnings? For they shall what? Rejoice and shall see the plummet in the hands of Zerubbabel. With those seven, they are what? The eyes of the Lord, which run to and fro to the what? The whole earth. So it's very important for us not to what? Despise our days of what? Little beginnings. Don't despise your days of what? Little beginnings. Please don't do that. There's a company called Daewoo. Do you know that company? Daewoo. They were into manufacturing. They were into cars sometimes. It's also a construction company as well. Daewoo started in somebody's garage. Somebody's what? Garage. Lakeside started where? Praise the Lord. Let's look at Job chapter 8 verse 7. There's somewhere I'm going. Follow me. Job 8:7. Remember, achievable, attainable. Do not always what involve God in what? Whatever you're doing. At the planning phase, involve him. And then what? Don't despise your what? Days of what? Little beginning. Don't. It says, though thy beginning was small, what? Yet thy later end shall what? Greatly increase. Your beginning may be small. You may be having one keke. But do you know that it is possible to you, for you to have fleet of kekes? And not just keke, you now graduate. But you also need to encourage yourself. It says, though thy beginning was small, yet thy later end world should what? Greatly increase. I speak increase over everybody that's here in Jesus' name. You will increase in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You will attain your goals in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's move on. Let's look at Isaiah 60 verse 22. This one is one of mommy's. This is mommy's scripture. In fact, I have to take permission before I read this one. Isaiah what? 60 verse 22. Put it on the screen. Let's read it. This one is an anthem. It should be an anthem in this church. It says, the least will become what?
A thousand.
The smallest what? A mighty nation. I am the Lord. I will accomplish it quickly in its time. Take us to King James. Let's read it in the King James. That's mommy's own. It's our motto. We should, anytime we are coming to church, we should stand and be dancing. A little one shall what? Become a thousand, a small one, a strong nation. I, the Lord, will hasten it in its what? In its time. No hurry. Attainable goals. Take time. Get God involved. Don't despise the days of your little beginning. You are small now, but it doesn't mean you will be small forever. Doesn't mean that you will be small forever. I've said this thing before and I'll keep saying it. I don't belong to the school of thought of people that like to describe people based on their current predicament or status or situation. This young woman here might be here. She might be here today now. But it doesn't mean that she'll be here forever. You might be seeing her with you now, sitting down now. Before you know what's happening now, she's in where? She's in Beijing, China. Beijing, China. And then she starts sending human hair to Nigeria to sell.
Glory.
Beijing. Do you know where Beijing is? Yeah, okay. Go and find her. Go and get the map and find her. And start knowing now. Find out where the Chinese embassy is. I'm telling you now. Some of us, you want to travel abroad. When they ask you, okay, where would you like to travel to? You. Italy. Do you know where the Italian embassy is in Nigeria? Okay. So that's the first thing. You cannot just jump on a plane and say you are going to Italy. You have to know where the Italian consulate is in Nigeria. There's an Italian consulate. That's where you go for an interview. Then before you get your visa to what? To travel. So know where it is. That's the number one. Anywhere you want to go to in this world, first thing you need to do is what? Know where the embassy is. Israel, where do you want to go to? US. Do you know where the US embassy is? They have an office in Port Harcourt, but they have their main office is in Lagos. They also have an office in Abuja. They have the U.S. consulate. I know those consulates are a representation of the countries here in Nigeria. So you go there, interviews, and then you get your visa. I see us getting our visas and traveling in Jesus' name. So achievable goals, attainable goals, God must be involved. We must not despise the days of our little beginning. And then we must have faith and believe that God will increase us. And then we must be diligent at what we do. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's look at our realistic goals. Look at your neighbor and say, realistic goals. Realistic goals. I'm trying to rush. Now, realistic goals are those you know you can what achieve. Your goals must be realistic. How do we know that we are chasing realistic goals? Number one, you ask yourself, do I have knowledge and experience to surmount the hurdles between me and these goals? The goals that you have set for yourself, do you have the knowledge? Do you have the effrontery? Do you have the wisdom? Do you have the capacity to achieve those goals? That's when you will know that those goals are what? Realistic. You know, it is nice to be in church. Listen to me. It is nice to be in church, and then I say, you will drive your Bugatti Veyron in the name of Jesus. Yeah, amen. I see you traveling abroad. Amen. That's okay. I don't have any problem with that. I'm not trying to make mockery of that. That's okay. But you see, you must balance. As a Christian, you must be able to, you must have a balanced perspective of life. And you must also account for what reality. When you're setting your goals and everything, you must be what? Realistic. You must be what? Realistic. Let's look at Psalms 23 verse 4. Let me show you something there. Psalms 23 verse what? Verse 4. We'll read it together. Psalms 23 verse 4. Are you being blessed this morning? Psalms 23 verse 4. Psalms 23 verse 4. It says what? Yet though I walk through the valley of the shadow of what? Of death. I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. It says what? Yea, I walk through. Did he say, yea, I fly through? Yea, I what? Fly through. Is that what is written there? It says, yea, I will disappear through. Is that what's there? It says, yea, I walk through the valley. So now what is David saying? David is saying that I know, say, I go walk out in through the what? The valley of it. David was being, he was what? Being real. He says, but what? He says, yeah, I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. So even in spite of all the God day. Look at your neighbor and say, God day. Just like what happened to our brother. Hey, give me your phone. Hey, when they reach in keke, oh boy, how far? Huh? Oh boy, how far? And then they let him go. So the fact that you are a Christian does not mean that you will escape trials and tribulations and problems. Problems will always be there. Problems will always what? Be there. Problems are what? They are part of reality. Do you understand? They are part of what? Reality. So some of us, the problem with us as Christians is that we feel like when we've given our life to Christ, it means that our problems have what? Ended. It's a lie. Oh. It is a what? It is a lie. But the truth about the matter is that God has empowered us to be able what? To live above, to overcome those challenges, those problems, those trials, those tempests, those tribulations. We are overcomers, aren't we? We are overcomers. But the power to overcome does not take away the reality. That's what I'm trying to make you understand. That's why it is here. It's on the, put that scripture back for me. The power to overcome. It says, yet though I walk. He didn't say run. He didn't say fly. He said, I walk. I go through the problem, but what? God day with me. So when we are making our, when we are planning for the year 2021, we should be what? We should be real. Praise the Lord. We should what? Also take into account reality. You understand? But in spite of that reality, also know that in spite of the challenges that will come with the reality, God has already made a way for you. God has what? Already made a way for what? For you. God has made a way for you. Put your right hand on your chest and say, God has made a way for me. He has made a way for all of us. There's a song that says, you made a way. God is a way maker. He's a way maker. Praise the Lord. Let's move on because I'm out of time now. So the last one is what? T. Your goals must what? Your goals must be timely. Look at your neighbor and say, my goals must be timely. In other words, there must be a time frame. Huh? For your goals. You cannot just have a goal. Say, I want to. Maybe you are big and you want to lose weight. Some people want to. Is there anybody that, okay, maybe you want to gain weight. How many of you want to gain weight here? Me, I want to gain weight. Mrs. is saying no. Praise the Lord. So if you want to set goals and achieve them, you will need what? A deadline. You need what? A deadline. You cannot just be planning and living and indefinitely. Procrastination. So when you go be, when you go start the building, say, my God, they see you. I'm not sure. Like you say, it will be 2025. You have managed to buy the land. Now to dig the foundation now. When you go dig the foundation, you cannot answer. No time. No time frame. You just did. So you must give yourself time. Let me give you an example. Now, we talked about, your goals must be measurable. Where we said that, I was trying to make you understand something where I said, I want to what, save 500,000. Now, under timely, you should be able to set the time that you want to save that what, 500,000. You cannot be saving 500,000 for what, 25 years. What thing happen? Now your case, 9 bad pass. Absolutely not. So you tell yourself, I want to be able to save what, 500,000 in 12 months. That goal what becomes what? There's not a time frame attached to it. Praise the Lord. So whatever goals we are setting for ourselves in 2021, there must be a time frame attached to that goal. And then you must be working actively what to achieve it. So don't be afraid. There's something I know. I know that as we are planning our own, God, the world and circumstances too will be planning its own. Do you understand? We know that. That one is it's part of life. That's the reality we're talking about. But it doesn't matter because, things are going this way. It does not matter that, it does not mean that we are not going to do what? Achieve. It doesn't mean that. It's just like when people are planning, soldiers are planning. Maybe they want to go and maybe there's a confrontation somewhere. And soldiers are planning to invade a particular place. As they sit down, they are planning their own contingencies and everything. The enemy is what? Equally planning. So they will tell themselves, we'll come from here. You people will flank from the left. The other people will flank from the right. You people then will meet somewhere. And then they always have those their plan. This battalion will come from the right. If this battalion is, this other one will come from the back. And then, as you do your own battalion, will come from the back. This other, the enemy too is saying, I know they will be coming from this side. So push them this side. When they come from, we drop the bomb. But because the enemy is planning, does it stop you from planning? The enemy's plan does not stop us from planning. Because we have a big God on our side. Do you have a big God? I have a big God. We serve a God. We serve a big God. The heaven is his throne. The earth is his footstool. It says, no weapon that is fashioned against you shall what shall prosper. No weapon. So it's a lie. Let the devil be doing his own. Do his own left, right, and center. It's a lie. This year, whatever you have set out to achieve this year, you will achieve it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You will achieve it. Goals must have a time frame. Goals must have a time frame. And because we are children of God, God, in his infinite mercies and wisdom, will make sure that those plans will come to reality in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's look at two scriptures and then we stand up and pray. Let's look at Psalms chapter 90 verse 12. After that, we'll look at one more scripture and then we stand to pray. Are you blessed this morning?
Yes.
It says, Psalms chapter 90, not this one. It says what? So teach us to number our days that we may apply our hearts unto what? Wisdom. Time. Put it in HSCB for me. The other translation. Teach us to number our days carefully so that we may develop wisdom in our hearts. To number your days means it's talking about time there. To number, to count. Teach us to count our days carefully so that we may develop wisdom in our what? Hearts. I see God giving us wisdom in our hearts in the name of Jesus. If you don't have wisdom here, receive wisdom in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Receive wisdom because you need wisdom. The Bible says what? Wisdom is what? The principal thing. It says in all thy getting, you must get wisdom. You must get understanding. Huh? You must get wisdom. You must get understanding because those things are what? That is what made Solomon stand out. Wisdom. And the Bible says that the greater than Solomon is here. The people that are seated here are greater than Solomon. Everybody put together. So wisdom. God will give us wisdom to succeed in 2021 in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's look at our final scripture. Final scripture. Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 1. Stand to your feet. Let's read it together. Ecclesiastes what? 3 verse 1. That's our final scripture. Stand to your feet as we read it. It says what? There is an occasion for everything. Eh? There is what? An occasion for everything. And a time for every activity what? Under the earth. Under heaven, sorry. Let's read it together. One, two, go. There is an occasion for everything. And a time for every activity under the earth. There is a time. There's a time. There is a specific time for you to own a house. There's a time for you to own a car. There's a time for you to have children. There's a time for you to train them in school. There's a time for you to run a business. There's a time. There's a time for everything. And I pray that you will not miss your time in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You will not miss your time. You will make quality use of your time. Because all of us have time here. We're time bound. Even life itself is timed. Not be so? Yes. Time. Let's read it in King James. Let's read it in King James. And then we pray. One, two, go. To every there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. It says to everything there is a season. There's what? There's a season. Have you seen mango in July before? Does mango come out in July? When does mango come out? February, March, Abi? You see mango in July. Even corn too. Corn has its time. When is corn? When is corn here? There's sometimes you will not see corn. Eh? Corn will now be scarce. Because what, there's a time to everything. I know mango is around that February, March, because we have one here. So I can remember when I was still here. I know that it's that February, March. That's when you do now come out like that. So to everything, there's a season and there's a time for purpose under the earth. Amen. Are you blessed today? Are you blessed? Did you learn something? Now, like I said, this whole text I have here will be on the church YouTube channel and it will be on the Facebook page. So if you're not following us on Facebook, please follow us on Facebook. Pillar of Truth Liberation Center. Those of you that have a smartphone, you can follow us on Facebook so that you can get this. The message will be up on the YouTube channel by, let's say, in the next maybe 2 hours. By 2 p.m. it should be there on the YouTube channel so that you can listen to it again and again. Come on, raise your hands up. Raise your hands up. And thank God. Thank Him for 2021. Thank Him for giving you the grace.